Hi guys, Jordan with Motion Array, and today we're taking a look at how to get a classic film roll effect. We're going to create this from scratch right here in Premiere Pro, and we're actually taking the inspiration for this effect from one of our film roll presets. It's this one here, and guess what? It's free! So if you wanted to download it and use it for inspiration, or compare it against the one you're about to create, the link to find it is in the description below. So we're actually going to create a transition that looks like this one here. But how do we go about actually creating this effect? Well, let's get started and find out. First things first, bring two pieces of footage onto your timeline. A clip to start with, and then when the transition occurs, another clip to transition into. Cut them down to the amount that you want them to actually last for, and including the amount of time that you want to have that transition take place over, which, depending on your preference, will be roughly between 12 to 24 frames. Cool, now let's go ahead and create an adjustment layer. Right-click on your project manager and choose New Item, Adjustment Layer. Take your adjustment layer and place it over top of the cut between your two clips. And then cut it down in size so it's roughly the same size on each side of the cut and lasting for about as long as you want the actual transition to last for. Now that that's done, we're ready to actually start creating this effect. The basis of this film roll effect comes down to an effect in Premiere called Offset. The Offset effect can be found in your Effects folder, and we can search for it and find it under Video Effects, Distort, Offset. And when we drag and drop it onto our adjustment layer, we should see no difference. But if we highlight our adjustment layer and go to our Effect Controls panel, we can see the Offset capability here. So let's move it around and see what happens to our clip. If we take the second parameter here, which controls the vertical y-axis movement, and click and drag it around, we can see that it starts to repeat like it's on a long film strip. As soon as the bottom bit goes off screen, it comes back again on the top. Great, so you might be able to start seeing how this effect can be used to make a transition. We're going to reset everything, and now we're going to set a keyframe a bit before the cut point where we want the transition to actually start. Then we're going to go all the way to when we want the transition to end on the other side of the cut, and make a keyframe. But with this keyframe, we want to offset our parameter. We're going to take this y-axis control and move it so that it makes about two complete cycles. Try and line it up at the end so that it's perfectly flush with the edge. If you need to make very fine changes, holding Control or Command while clicking and dragging this parameter will allow you to make really rapid mouse movements while making only very fine, small, and subtle changes to the effect. Great! So now this is what the effect should look like so far. It's actually not that bad already at this point. We still have a lot more that we need to do with this, but this is really the structural element of this effect completed. The rest is just going to be stylizing. Let's add some realism to this. Let's create a ramp in and out of this effect by giving our keyframes a bezier. Highlighting your keyframes and then right-clicking them will allow you to select the bezier here. And now your keyframe diamonds should look a lot more like hourglasses. Now let's drop down this arrow here and we can see the velocity parameters that we can now play with as well. Grab these points here and bring them all the way down. And then drag out these markers here to give a more of a curvature to the speed over time, so that it starts slow and then explodes into motion. And the graph should look something like this when we're all done. And just for reference, there's about 12 frames in between these two keyframes for me. And at this point, you can see where the most velocity takes place at the peak of this graph here. It really helps the effect if you have this point of greatest velocity at the point where the cut happens between your two clips. To do this, let's bring the playhead to our cut point here on our timeline. And then we can see that point in our graph over here. So let's highlight both of our keyframes and then move them over so that the two places line up. Great! Now you can see that if we go frame by frame through this, our clip keeps all of its detail and sharpness as it moves. But in real life, there would be some blur to it. So let's go to our effects panel and search for the directional blur effect under Video Effects, Blur and Sharpen. Now let's drag and drop it onto our adjustment layer. And we can see that if we increase the blur length, we can see that it looks like our footage is moving in a more specific direction. And because our effect is going in the top-down direction, we can leave the blur direction at 0 degrees. But say, for example, that we wanted it to go to the left and right direction, we would change it to be 90 degrees. But for this example, let's just leave it at 0. But now we need to keyframe the blur to match the amount of movement that the clip is going through. Go to the starting keyframe of your rolling motion, and set the keyframe for the blur length just to stay at 0. And then do the same thing again for the ending keyframe. Now go to the center of the effect at the peak of your offset velocity, and make a third keyframe for blur length. But this time, ramp up the blur length to the maximum amount that you want your footage to experience. So now if we give the middle keyframe here a bezier, and then move it so that the angle of it looks similar to the shape of the peak of the offset movement, this is what we get. It looks like the motion is actually causing the motion blur. Awesome! So our effect looks really great now, and it's at a place that if this is what you were going for stylistically, you could potentially call it done. But we're going to be doing a little bit more to really set this effect apart. Next, what we're going to do is make the image pull back before shuffling to the new frame. The way we're going to do this is actually very simple, but there's one crucial step. You need to insert another adjustment layer underneath the one that you just created. So move the current one up a track by either dragging it or highlighting it and then holding the Alt or Option key and hitting the up arrow. Now you can take the same adjustment layer file from your project window, but just make sure to insert it directly underneath the one that you've been working with up until now. If you want to keep track of which is which, I would highly suggest right-clicking each one and renaming it. Because the top one holds the offset and directional blur effects, I'm just going to name it Offset and Directional Blur. Then for the bottom one, we haven't added any effects to it yet, but I'm going to name it in advance of what we're going to be doing by naming it Transform and Gaussian Blur. Great! Now we can see easily what each one of these is doing at a glance. Okay, so we're getting really close. So next up, we're going to be adding the transform property to this bottom adjustment layer. Once you've added it in, we're really only going to be focusing on the scaling option. So we're going to be reverse engineering this a bit by going to the frame where the offset roll starts to happen, and then set a keyframe. Then go back a few frames and set another one. Go back to the other keyframe now at the point where the roll starts to happen and scale down your clip. And you'll notice that the whole frame shrinks. And not only that, but when you start to play it forwards again, the rolling offset still happens all the way down the screen even though the size of the frame has shrunk. This is why we manage the scaling in a separate adjustment layer. And now we just need to keyframe the opposite once the rolling is finished to get us back to full size. And we're so close, but we're just going to add one more finishing touch. We're going to add a Gaussian blur to the bottom adjustment layer. And now we're going to keyframe it so that as the frame gets smaller, it gets blurrier. This will make it look like it's moving farther away by moving out of focus. For me, about 65 was enough to make this effect look really great. And it also gives a nice natural rounding to the sharp corners of the frame. Just make sure to leave repeat edge pixels unchecked. Awesome! So once you finally keyframe those from 0 to 65, and then back again to 0, you should be left with this. And guys, that's how you create your own custom film roll transition. But there's one last little bit of flair that you can really give to set it apart. I'm going to add a clip from a pack of motion array light leaks on top of everything that we've just done. To make the light leaks look correct, I'm just going to set the blending mode to screen, and then keyframe it to start at 0, and then ramp up only once the frame gets pulled back. This makes it look like the footage is actually right up against a sensor, and once you pull it away, it's like you're letting light hit the real sensor, causing light leaks. It gives it a really nice realistic effect. And because there's so much blue in our shots, I'm just going to search for the HLS color balance effect, and then change the hue degree so that it's less red and more blue. And this is our true final result. Guys, I hope you found this video helpful. Like we mentioned before, if you wanted to pick up this free pack of film roll presets, the link to that is in the description below. And if any of the stock clips we used or the light leaks we added at the end were something that you wanted to look at, we have links to each of those as well. If you guys like this video, give it a like or share it so that it gets even more likes, and subscribe to our channel and click the bell icon to keep up to date with whatever we post. And if you pick up anything from our Motion Array marketplace, make sure to use the discount code in the description below to get 20% off your first month's subscription. Thank you so much for watching, and I can't wait to see you in the next video.